Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about perpendicular bisectors, and we're going to do a dynamic drawing of one. A perpendicular bisector is a line that bisects something into two congruent or equal parts. So let's begin. I'm going to start here with the segment tool, and with the segment tool I'm going to create two points. At this point I've created segment AB. Next I'm going to select my circle tool, and again this is the metaphor for a compass where the sharp end goes on point A, and I'm going to draw a circle of a given radius, and I'm going to make the circle about here. Next I'm going to go here to point B again and draw another circle with a given radius, and what my goal is to have those two circles intersect each other, because once they intersect, at that point I'm going to be able to create my line bisector. So I can go very large, or at this point I can go very small. It just depends on where I want to create the angle bisector. At this point I'm going to stop right here. I want to create my angle bisector at this point here. Next, I want to go and place a point on the two locations where the two circles intersect. So from the toolbar, I'm going to select my intersection tool and create point E, and then come down here to this bottom intersection and create point F. Now I've set myself up to actually draw my perpendicular bisector. That's going to go from point E down to point F. I'm going to go back to my line segment tool, starting at point E,
going down here
to point F, and just place my point. So now I have my line bisector, and I also need, or for this demonstration, I want to place a point here on the intersection between my perpendicular bisector and the line segment that I started with. So I'm gonna go back to my intersection tool and place that point here, and that would be point G. All right, now I want to get rid of some of the complexity that we see here on the screen by actually hiding my circles. And again, the circles are still a part of the drawing. They're just being hidden so that we can easily see the line segment that I started out with, AB, and the perpendicular bisector here, EF. All right, what I want to do next is actually use my angle tool, and I want to show the angles created when perpendicular bisector EF was constructed. So starting at point B, going in a clockwise manner, I'm going to select B, G, and E. Now you see that's going to give me a 90 degree angle here, alpha showing 90 degrees for angle EGB, and I'm going to go ahead and also show the angle angle AGE as well. I want to go ahead and show what that measure is. So again, going in a clockwise fashion, I'm going to select angle point E down to G, and then A. Back to my move tool, and we'll see that angle beta is also 90 degrees. And then to use the power of this GeoGebra tool that I'm using, I want to be able to manipulate point B, and we still see that alpha and beta remain at 90 degrees. And I'm going to go back here to point A, and we still see the same behavior where this perpendicular bisector is being maintained as I move the endpoint of one of the segments. All right, so I want to end here with the perpendicular bisector video. And again, please stay tuned to Speller Tutorial Services. We'll have more videos coming soon. Thank you.